So in the last session, we have started with the design of single reinforced beams, and we have seen some pertaining to it. Just looking at the brief overview of the last sum that we discussed, the basic methodology of designing a beam depends upon the assumption. So we assumed that the section is balanced. Whenever we will be designing a singly reinforced beam, we will be always assuming that the section is balanced. That means the XU will be equal to XUmax and MU will be equal to MU lim. Okay? So by the means of MU lim, we will be calculating the dimensions. To design a purpose or to design a structure, that means to identify two basic things. That is to first identify the dimensions and then the detailing portion. So our entire design process in the entire syllabus, whether we'll be talking upon either beam sections, either column sections, RCC sections, that is foundations, or you can say the slabs. In all these cases, or all the structural members, our basic designing will be divided into two parts. That is, one is dimensioning and the other is our detailing portion. Dimensioning means in the case of beams, we need to find the cross-sectional area. That means we need to calculate the amount of width and the amount of depth that will be needed to support the loading conditions. And in the detailing portion, we will be always finding the bars, or the, you can say, the reinforcement bars that will be needed, and that will be helping or will be needing the help of our steel tables. Either you can opt for manual method or you can opt for steel tables, but steel tables will be preferred more as compared to the manual method, because steel tables are allowed in our examination too, and in the future scenarios to solve the problems and to minimize the efforts that you will be putting across, because the time of examination is very less and the lengthy syllabus is cut there. So to reduce the efforts, we will be always using our steel table. Yeah? So this was the basic overview of what we will be designing. Now moving across our today's sum, the question here about the today's sum here is, design a singly RC beam with effective depth equal to twice the width of beam. This was the sum that we talked about yesterday. Just we'll be talking a brief overview of it, and we'll be seeing how to calculate it from the method, that is from the steel table. So to resist a factor moment of 120 kN, we need to use M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. So here, keep in mind, whenever we will be designing a singly reinforced beam, we will be always assuming that the section is balanced. Because whenever we will be assuming the section to be balanced, we can opt to for the thing, that is MU will be equal to MU lim. So here, MU is given in the question, but keep in mind the wordings, that is the statement ahead of it, it is very important pertaining to our entire sum. Okay? If it is mentioned as if the moment to be given is factored, either a design or ultimate, if any of these three words are being present in our question, then there is no need to multiply the load or moment by our factor of safety, that is 1.5 in the case of RCC. Yeah? So as it is given in the question that it is a factored moment, there is no need to multiply it by 1.5. So we'll be directly using this case, and we'll be taking the equation for MU lim. Again, this equation is not given in our textbook, or you can say not given in our IS code itself. So you need to remember this, because it is present in SP16, and SP16 is not allowed in our examination. So the equation here is 0.13 tepck bd square. 0.13, why we are opting for? Because we are dealing with Fe415 steel. For Fe415 steel, our equation will always be 0.13 tepck bd square. Clear? So now this MU lim will be considered to be MU, because we are taking it to be a balanced section. 0.138 fck will be 20, because it is given to be a M20 concrete. D is our unknown, and it is mentioned that the depth is equal to twice the width. Therefore, in the case of D, we'll be substituting the term 2B, that is twice the width. Okay? So from this, we are getting the value of B, that is our width. And from this, we'll be calculating the value of RD. Keep in mind, we will be always rounding it off to a higher value, that is a round figure value. Okay? In this case, we are actually getting answer to be 221.5. But for the sake of simplicity, we will be always rounding it off to the higher value in a whole number. So we'll be opting for 230 mm. And according to 230 mm, we'll be finding the depth of the section. So depth of the section here comes out to be 460 mm. Now moving forward, the next step will be to detailing. That means to find the detailing of the structure, or you can say to find the reinforcements. So for finding the reinforcements, or to find the AST, that is area of steeling tension, the first thing that we need to do is to find the value of PT. PT is percentage of tension reinforcement. That means out of the whole cross section area, which is 230 mm cross 460 mm, that is effective, what amount of steel will be used, or how much content of steel will be used, what percentage? Clear? So that is our PT, percentage of tension reinforcement. So for that, again, this equation is not being present in our IS code, so we will be again remembering it because it is given in our SP16. So the equation here is 50 FCK by FY, 1 minus under root 1 minus 4.6 mu upon FCK BD square. Mu will be obtained this value that is given in our quotient. So B and D we have calculated it. So out of all these things, or we can say of substituting every value in this case, we are getting the value of PT to be 0.824%. That means out of the whole cross section area, the total amount of steel that is being present to counteract the tension forces is just 0.824%. Clear? So from this, we will be finding the value of our AST, that is our area of steeling tension. So the equation for the same is PT BD by 100. PT, that is our percentage of tension reinforcement, B will be our width of section, and D, that is our effective depth. So solving it, we are getting an answer 871.79 mm square. Now after finding the area of steel, we always need to opt for the amount of bars, or you can say number of bars. So first for that, we'll be finalizing the bar diameter. Either we'll be opting for a manual method, or you will be opting for the steel table method. We'll be finalizing the bar diameter. Here we are taking the bar diameter to be 20 mm. So a single bar, that is area of a single bar, will be pi by 4 into b square. So that comes out to be 314.15. Total area that is to be counteracted is 871.79, out of which one bar has a cross section area of 314.15. So from this, we will be calculating the total number of bars that can be used. So here number of bars is comes out to be 2.77. So rounding it off, we are getting the value of 3. Now, this is the area of steel provided. That is how much content we are providing. This value was the area of steel required. That means to sustain this amount of moment, that is 120 kilonewton meter, that is given in our quotient, we need at least 2.77 number of bars. But 2.7 number of bars cannot be provided in any structure, so we'll be rounding it off. So after rounding it off to the value that is 3, we are providing some extra steel. So that extra amount of steel we always need to mention in our answer. So that is AST provided, which comes out to be 942.45 mm square. So the final answer is that providing 3 numbers of 20 mm diameter bars. And now moving on to the second method, that is our using steel table. So for that, we will be always using this range, that is between 2 to 6 mm, and we will be using the diameter, that is 12 to 24. So from this, the minimum content or minimum AST that is required is 8.71 in centimeter square. So we will be looking in this case, or in this table, the value that is higher than 8.71, and the value that is higher than 8.71 falls in this category, that is 9.42. Clear? So if we go horizontally, we can see the bar diameter, that is 20, and if we go vertical, then we are getting the number of bars. It is not mandatory to provide the same thing that I have provided, but just you need to know that whatever the number of bars are you providing, it the total area, that is the total cross section area, should always be greater than what is required, clear? To satisfy our conditions. So this is how you will be proceeding ahead in the design of CR singly reinforced beam. So this is the final answer that I have just touched upon. And moving on to our next sum, the question here is, design a rectangular RCC beam that is simply supported over an effective span of 4 meter loaded with a service load of 25 kilometer per meter. Keep in mind, here it is given service load. It is not mentioned that the load is factored. It is not mentioned that the load is design load, and it is again not mentioned that the load is ultimate load. If these three words are not present in our question, then the first step will be to multiply the given load or moment by our factor of safety, that is 1.5. Okay? So in this sum, the starting portion will be to multiply the given load by 1.5. And it says including self-weight. Keep in mind, if it is given in the question that the load that is being prescribed is including self-weight, then there is no need to find self-weight. So rho BED won't be used in this case that we have used in the earlier sessions. And also it has been given that we will be using M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. The partial safety factor will be 1.5, just as I said. If it is not being prescribed in our question itself, then also we'll be always checking the partial safety factor, that is our factor of safety, to be 1.5. The width of beam is given as 250 mm. So the first part, that was our dimensioning part, the half portion is being prescribed. That means the width of the section is being given. We just need to focus on finding the depth of section. And again, we'll be proceeding ahead. The diameters that will be given, you can say the data that are being given is FCK equal to 20 Newton per mm square and FY equal to 4.5 Newton per mm square. The factored load, the first thing, as just I said, that after calculating this, there is a service load is being given. So the first step will be to find the factored load. So factored load in this case comes out to be 37.5 kilonewton per meter. And then we'll be calculating the moment regarding it, as it is being given in the question that the beam is simply supported. So the maximum bending moment will be WL square by 8. So WL square by 8, the final answer that comes out is 75 kilonewton meter. So after calculating the moment, we'll be assuming, because for every design problem that will be pertaining across our single reinforced beam, we'll be always assuming that the section is balanced. Clear? So we'll be assuming MU equal to MU lim. So solving it, we are getting the small d, that is our effective depth, to be 330 mm. So the b, that is width of section, was already given in the question, and effective depth is now being calculated. So the first part, that is our dimensioning part, is completed. Now we'll be moving across the second part, that is our detailing part. And detailing part, that means to find the area of steel. For that, the first thing that we'll be doing is to find the value of PT again. So PT in this case comes out to be 0.952. That means out of the total cross-section area, the total steel that is required to sustain this amount of moment is just 0.952%. And according to this, we'll be finding the minimum area of steel required. Clear? Then keep in mind, the after the this step, that we'll be finding the value of AST from the equation, that is PT BD by 100. That gives the answer of our minimum steel required. So the minimum steel required here will be 785.4 mm square, and from this, that is from our steel table, we'll be looking upon a value that is greater than 7.85. so the value that is greater than 7.85 comes across this case, that is 804, as you can see here, 8.04. so we have provided four numbers of 16 mm diameter. It is again not mandatory to provide the same thing that is providing by me. So you just need to focus that the minimum reinforcement to be provided is 7.85 cm square. So from this table, you need to find the value in the range itself. That means the minimum diameter should be 12 mm, the maximum diameter should be 24 mm, and the minimum number of bars should be 2, maximum number of bars should be 6. Out of this range, means in between this range, you can opt for any combination that is being possible. Yeah? So this is how we'll be solving our design problem. And just as I said, this is our design problem. And moving across our third sum of today, the question here is, a beam 200 x 300 mm effective is used as a 2 meter cantilever beam. Again, keep in mind, it is a cantilever beam. Most of the students make mistake here in the equation for MU, that is our bending moment. To support a factored load of 15 kN per meter, the load is already given as factored load, so there is no need to multiply it by 1.5. We need to calculate the area of tension steel, that means we need to find AST. Also check for deflection. This is something new that we'll be looking upon. Here we are supposed to find the deflection, that whether after sustaining this amount of load and after providing the content of steel, whether our beam will sustain the deflection that is occurring in this section or not. Again, we'll be using M20 concrete and Fe415 steel. So the first thing that we'll be doing is to find the self weight, because it is not being prescribed in the question that 15 kilonewton per meter is including its self weight. If it is not given in the question that it is including in self weight, then the first step will be to find the self weight of the section. So self weight of the section here comes out to be 2.652 kilonewton per meter from the equation that is rho BD. Rho, that is density of RCC, that will be taking as 25 kilonewton per meter cube. B, that is our width of section, and D will be our capital D, keep in mind here, overall depth. And then we will be finding the total factor load, that is a combination of the load that has been given in the question and the addition of the self weight. So the total UDL, that is factor UDL, comes out to be 17.625 kilometer per meter. Then we will be calculating the value of MU. Keep in mind again, the beam is given as cantilever beam, so the equation for bending, maximum bending moment will be WL square by 2. Here is a printing mistake, it is the WL square by 2, so keep in mind the value will be 35.25 kilonewton into meter, and MU will be again from the same equation, that is 0.13 FCKVD square. So as you can see, MU is less than MU limit, it is under imposed section. So the next step again will be to find the value of AST from the same equation. We need to find the value of PT. Here PT comes out to be 0.624%, clear? And from that we will be finding the value of AST. AST here comes out to be 374.4 mm square. So from the steel table itself, we will be finding the total number of steel that will be required. So we will be providing four numbers of 12 mm diameter. As you can see here, four numbers of 12 mm diameter, that means this case, that is 4.52 mm square, we will be providing our, or you can say 4.52 centimeter square of steel we will be providing, that is greater than 3.74 centimeter square. Clear? So this is the design problem that we have completed, and now we'll be focusing on the second part, that is check for deflection. And to check for deflection, we'll be always moving to our page number 37 of your IS code. So pause this video and move on to page number 37 of your IS code. Here you can see that clause number 23.2.1 is being mentioned, and here it is mentioned that basic values of span to effective depth ratio for span up to 10 meter has been given. Clear? So L by D ratios are to be calculated. L by D ratios for three different cases are being given. Here in the question it is mentioned that the beam that will be dealing with is cantilever, so our ratio will be 7. But again, keep in mind there is a printing mistake in this code. It is 7 multiplied by NF, that is our modification factor. You won't be doing any corrections in the IS code, either by pencil or pen or anything. You know, just need to remember it. So keep in mind the value will be 7 into MF. For simply support it, it will be 20 into MF, and for continuous it will be 26 into MF. Now what is MF? So MF is modification factor, and that will be obtained from next page, that is page number 38 from figure number 4. Here you can see that we need to see the percentage of tension reinforcement, and from this y-axis we'll be calculating the modification factor from the curves of FS that are being given in the figure itself. Yeah? So the first thing will be to find the value of PT. PT will be according to the steel that has been provided, not the PT value that we just calculated in the previous slide. Yeah? So the first thing will be to calculate the value of PT according to AST that has been provided. So the PT value here comes out to be 0.753. Then the actual L by D will be calculating. Actual L, that is actual length, is given in the question to be 2 meter. So that will be 2000 mm multiplied by depth. We have already calculated the depth of the section to be 300 mm. It is given in the question itself. So the answer, that is actual L by D, comes out to be 6.66. Clear? And now we'll be moving across to the value of MF. So 0.753, PT 0.753 means it will be somewhere around here, less than 0.8. So now we'll be focusing on this curve, that is the curve of FS. And to find the value of FS, the equation is being prescribed here. That is FS equal to 0.58 FY. FY is 415, and area of cross section of steel required upon area of cross section of steel provided. We already have AST required and AST provided. So solving that, we'll be getting the value, something FS equal to 250, So here, as you can see, fs will be equal to 250. Maximum L by D will be, as we saw in the previous slide, for cantilever it will be 7 into mf. So calculating this, mf comes out to be 1.05. That means fs equal to 240 means this curve will be talking upon, and we'll be taking this line somewhere here. Okay? So here the final answer comes around somewhere here, that is greater than 1. So we'll be taking the mf value to be 1.05. it is not mandatory to take the same value, it is up just according to your perception what value you are getting. We just need to prove that the actual L by D is less than maximum L by D. That's it. Well, to check for deflection, maximum L by D here comes out to be 7.53, and the actual L by D that we calculated was 6.66. So as 6.66 is less than 7.53, our structure is safe against deflection. So this is how we'll be checking the deflection in our singly reinforced beams. So this is our exercise problem for today. Do solve it and do practice it and keep on practicing, because it will be helpful in your examination. So in the next session, we will be seeing further more sums regarding our singly reinforced beam. Thank you.